Hello children, today's story is The Time Traveling River. Author Parinita Shetty, illustrator Sunaina Coelho, publisher Pratham Books, a level 3 story. Now let's get started with this story. And listen children, this story is re-recorded by me on special request of so many DMs by the children, and it is in a better version, in a better voice quality and picture quality. So you will really like this story, and do listen to this story and do not forget to subscribe our channel Smart Kids Wonder. Now let's get started with the story. Rivers are like time machines. If people jump into one and travel back far enough, they will be able to witness history come alive. No two rivers are alike. Their moods change depending on what time of year it is and which part of the country they are traveling through. Some rivers are peaceful in the winter. Some rivers are small and shy in the summer. Some rivers roar angrily in the monsoons. A river may be brown, grey, black, blue, green, or several other shades. They change their color based on what's inside them or what's around them. Sometimes they are the color of the rocks at the bottom of the river. Sometimes they match the color of the sky. Rivers also change their course. If a river is in one spot in the past, it may be somewhere else in the future. Many rivers like the Ganga are thousands of years old. They have seen humankind grow up. People have always loved living and working near rivers. Rivers know how to take care of people. Some of our food comes from rivers, and river water is used to grow most food. When the food has made its way through the body, rivers to the rescue again. If rivers could speak, they might demand people dump their poop somewhere else. Humans aren't the only creatures rivers look after. Many birds and plants, animals and fishes, insects and flowers rely on rivers. Rivers even support musical talent. Insects sing strange and wonderful songs underwater, which sound like they are from another world. India gets its name from a river. Apart from naming the country, the Indus was home to one of the oldest civilizations in the world. The river helped the ancient people build cities. They used the river to travel to lands both near and far, carrying everything they wanted to buy and sell. The Indus Valley citizens lived beside the river quite happily, until suddenly they didn't. More than 3,000 years ago, the civilization vanished. Some people think they got a bit too greedy, that by overusing the forest and water, they made the river flood. Floods are scary, but sometimes they are useful. When floodwaters return to the river, they leave behind rich soil on the banks, perfect for growing crops. But floods can also destroy lives and buildings. Furious rivers frighten people. Ancient humans thought songs, prayers and gifts could calm the river down. It wasn't usually the best plan. Travel on the river time machine back to the present. Some things from the past will seem familiar. Rivers continue to be used for food and transport. People have also built canals to connect rivers, carry water to those who don't live near rivers, and to make it easy to travel on them. People construct dams to control the flow of rivers. store water and create electricity from the river's energy. But all this human meddling is messing up the rivers. Dams and canals make it harder for rivers to take care of all their creatures. Many people don't understand how rivers work, how rivers live, and how rivers die. In some areas, rivers have become as dry as deserts. In others, rivers are treated like rubbish bins, sewage pipes, and plastic dumps. If the river time machine takes people on a trip into the future, what will they see? A scene of empty rivers which live only in old stories. They will find states and countries at war over the few rivers which do exist. They will wander into a barren waste land. Isn't it scary? Or they will see a world in which humans have learned to live with nature and with each other. A world where fresh water is stored, wastewater is recycled, and both are used responsibly. They will find clean rivers and people who protect them. What do you want to see, children? Clean rivers, or you want to see those ugly ones? The second future isn't impossible. Our skills and technology have brought dead rivers back to life before. Rivers have taken care of us for thousands of years. Now some humans are trying to take care of our rivers. So, I think we can have a bright future, and it all depends on us, the humans, how we treat our nature, how we treat our rivers, and whether we want our rivers to be clean and alive. Some courts have decided that rivers have the same legal rights humans do. If someone damages a river, it will be like harming another person. Imagine the long list of complaints a river will have against people. So we must treat rivers very carefully and do not let them die. Do not let them become dirty. Do not let them go away and fade. Children are taking to the streets to demand a better future. In 2015, 11-year-old Stella Bowles campaigned her local government to fix the polluted river, and they did. Adults are beginning to listen. So the children can run campaigns for protection of rivers, and the adults can join in too for their support. All across the globe, children are telling adults that they need to do a better job of looking after the world they are leaving behind. It is the only one we have, after all. The work of cleaning rivers never ends. There will be more humans, more farms, more factories. Luckily, there is enough water for everyone. We just need to look after it and after each other. So what do you decide, children? Do you want to join in to create a better future for all of us? Or you want to leave behind a very bad place to live in for our generations to come? I hope you are going to make a better world ahead. Thank you, children. Happy learning.